welcome to another exciting morning on the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. We are talking about encouraging yourself in the Lord. Our study is coming this week from 1 Samuel chapter 30. It is Ziklag. This morning we want to consider, beloved, what Ziklag means for you and me. How do we run into these unexpected, cataclysmic situations, debacles, major problems? Can you imagine coming home and everybody's gone, house is burned down? Wow. David had 600 very fiercely loyal men with all their families, all these years running from Saul. And Ziklag came along. It was supposed to be a reprieve that became a disaster. Beloved, one of the things you must do to encourage yourself is to first diagnose yourself. How did I get here? If David had not run to the land of the Philistines to catch a reprieve from Saul, there would have been no Ziklag. And that move to Ziklag, beloved, opened the door for him to join the Philistine army to fight against Israel. I wanted to repeat those things because many believers, due to personal offense, these days find themselves fighting against God, fighting against men called of God, fighting against ministries ordained of God. Beloved, don't become an antichrist because of an offense. Remember, Jesus says, he that is not for me is against me. There is no neutral ground. God has not chosen you to war against himself. No, you've been deceived by Satan. Hear me, beloved. It was the lords of the Philistines that saved David from joining the war against Israel. Thank God. But it opened the door for a disaster. Beloved, that's the only thing you can expect. If you find yourself warring against God and his ministry, only disaster will come. I promise you that by the word of the Lord. Don't do it. You have not been called to it. Doesn't matter where you are on this earth listening to me. Don't join the enemies of God against the work of God. That is Satan's job, not yours. And so when David returned to Ziklag, everything was burned down. The families of all the 600 men were taken captive. And beloved, for the first time, these men that were so loyal to him talked about stoning David. Stoning David. Ooh, what a height of discouragement. What a height of despondency. Can you imagine the pain? Can you imagine you're dealing with the loss of your own family? And then these men that you've loved and walked with all these years were talking about stoning you. And yet David had something that most of us don't have, an inner sanctuary with the Lord his God. He could find God in distress. He said, David encouraged himself in the Lord. How did he do it? I love one phrase that we share in every funeral services. He says, what time I am afraid, I will trust in thee. Hallelujah. He said, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock higher than I. Beloved, there's nothing as wonderful as knowing the Lord personally. So you can put your head on his chest, the breasted one, El Shaddai. When all else fails, when friends desert, when people closest to you turn against you, you better know the Lord. So you can remember his promises. So you can restate his covenants with you. So you can remember his great deliverances in the past. And you take courage to know that this disaster can actually become a miracle, beloved. Oh, many times we find ourselves in the permissive will of God. That's what Ziklag is. And I'll take some time to talk about those permissive things tomorrow. But learn, beloved, that when men desert, when friends desert, when things are excruciating and very difficult, David encouraged himself in the Lord. You must do the same. I remind you again before I leave this morning, how should you do it? Worship him. How should you do it? Remember his promises. How should you do it? Remember his covenants. How should you do it? Testify of his goodness to you. He will show up and tell you what to do. God has given you the victory this morning. Shout out loud as you leave to go to work this morning. The victory is yours. Amen and amen. God bless you. Let's continue tomorrow. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you. Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.